What's up, guys? What's going on? It's Dredd, and I'm back with another video. We're on Madden 23, and we got the division rival Rams today on our San Francisco 49ers franchise. Big game in week two, already getting into some really important games. We got to make sure we come out on top here. If we want to start out the season on a high note, big win last week obviously helped a ton. Would love to keep that up, see what we can do. And I think we can. I mean, the Rams are definitely a good team. There's some stuff we're going to have to watch out for, but we got this. We're going to upgrade players really quick, and then we're going to hop straight into the game. Going to give Hufanga that run support boost up to a 73 overall. Nothing crazy for him. Honestly, I'm hoping he goes up more quick. But that was probably last season if that was going to happen. So I don't know if he will. Drake Jackson gets yet another boost after a great game in week one. Go check out that video. Watch him dominate because he really did kill it. He was one of our best players on defense. And as you can see from that score right there, it was a great game. We're going to hop into the game right here, right now. Let's get it. Let's see how it goes. All right, we're here. We're ready to go, ready to get it. See how this is going to go down. I never know what to expect. Every game is a totally new day. And we just got to try to come out on top each and every time. All right, first and 10 for the LA Rams. They're going to start out on their 25-yard line. After the quick touchback, handing off to Cam Akers. Fred Warner steps up, doesn't get the tackle. Dre Greenlaw does, but not before a 7-yard rush for Cam Akers. Cam Akers has been struggling immensely in real life, but in the game, he's an 86 overall. He had a nice carry there. So we're going to actually have to watch out for him. Out of everyone on this offense, he's the only one that makes me at all nervous other than Cooper Kupp. And Cooper Kupp is one receiver, so it's just constant. Bro, Ambry Thomas is the most insane corner of all time. I have no idea what Stafford was doing throwing that. But dude, Ambry Thomas is a ball hawk. I think he had two last week. He led the league in picks last year, and he's already got another this week. Just crazy. First and 10 here for the offense. Great game from Trey Lance last week. We're going to try to keep that hot streak going. Quick jet pass to Brandon Ayuk. Cuts it upfield and gets a short pickup. We'll take it. So these are always the tough decisions. Third and two. It looks like we should be able to pick up 2 yards, but that's Aaron Donald and Bobby Wagner. Regardless, we're going to go for it, and it's great blocking. Great blocking and a big pickup for Deebo Samuel. First and 10 from the 19-yard line down in the red zone. So in real life, the Niners just lost Jimmy G this last week. Not a good throw. Lance, got to get that out in front. They just lost Jimmy G. Broke his foot in the last game. Going to mix up the... I don't know what to expect from anything about this team the rest of the year from here on out. I'd love to say I have high expectations for him still. Brock Purdy looked decent in week one. He really did. It's hard to bet on him. You know, it really is hard to bet on it. Mayfield just got released. Maybe the Niners go pick him up. I really hope they don't. I hope they give Purdy a chance because I think Purdy has the potential to at least do what Jimmy did for him. You know, it might not be quite as good. But they were winning all their games with Jimmy. If he can go out there and win half the games the rest of the season and put them into a playoff position, maybe they make a run. Who knows? It's going to be interesting. But Niners fans, I assume that's most of who's watching this video as Trey Lance throws a dime to Brandon Ayuk after the Rams blitzed pretty much everyone. Touchdown, we go up 7-0. Drop a comment. Let me know how y'all are feeling about the team. You guys think you're going to have a shot to do something serious this year still? Or you think it's kind of over now? I think you're going to go pick someone else up? I've been seeing all sorts of rumors of things like Tom Brady's going to demand a release so he can go sign and win another ring. Same with like Matt Ryan since he's worked in Shanahan's system before. I personally don't think that's going to happen at all. But drop a comment. Let me know what you guys think is going to happen, what's going to go down. I'm excited to see it and read about it. Third and four now. Stafford got to throw it here. You'd imagine they're going to hand it off again. And Dre Greenlaw is on it. They might go for it here, though, honestly. They don't end up going for it. It's going to be a punt, and we are going to get the ball back to Trey Lance. First and 10 here. Trey Lance has the ball at the 5-yard line. Let's see what he can do. I kind of want to play it conservative and try to run it, but I feel like that's almost not the conservative call against the Rams. We're going to get the quick pass to Christian McCaffrey, but Jalen Ramsey does his thing. Third and 2 here. This is kind of a big play. Got to read that edge and see what he does. He's going to stay out there, so we're going to hand it off. It's close. They're gonna call us down short. You know what? We're gonna play gutsy. We're gonna play gutsy. You can't tell me that gap to the left is not wide open for at least a yard, and Trey Lance gets it for us, actually ends up picking two, almost three up. That's a first down. That's what we needed. Big play there from Trey. The number one thing I want to do is try to play conservative with this team. I feel like we've got a great squad as long as we can minimize the mistakes. That's what we did down the stretch last season. Ended up being really effective for us. I think it's what we got to do here. If we can manage to do that, we're going to come out on top a lot. This defense creates turnovers. The offense can score points. We move the ball well. We just got to protect it. And that's what we did last week. Ended up being a big win. That's what we're doing so far here. And we got a lead early on. I'm just excited to see what else we can do with it. If you guys have been enjoying this content, please do drop a like and drop a sub. I know I missed a decent little bit of time here the last couple weeks. My school Wi-Fi kind of dropped on my Xbox. I couldn't get on to record anything at all. Wasn't able to do that, unfortunately. But we're back. We're going to try to keep putting videos out as much as possible. I don't have that much work over the next couple weeks, so hopefully I can get a few extra videos out. That being said, it is finals week, so I gotta be aware of that too. But yeah, drop that like, drop that sub, keep checking these videos out. The support's been unreal on this series. It has been since day one on it, honestly. I just wanna keep building. I was clicking the button for Trey to throw to Kyle Juszczyk. He just didn't for some reason. We take a big sack there, that's not good. But yeah, I'd appreciate all the support. It's been awesome, and it's making me wanna keep doing this. It's making it a heck of a lot more fun. So if y'all would keep dropping those likes and subs, it'd mean a lot. We just need one broken tackle there, McCaffrey. Come on, man. So we're going to have a 3rd and 15 here. Got to find a way to convert. And what a phenomenal block by Deebo Samuel. Deebo just stands there, lets the guy run around him for no reason. We take the sack. It's going to be a punt. Rams get the ball back. All right, we got Jayon Brown, one of our free agent pickups out there at linebacker right now. See if he can get something going for us. And Nick Bosa is a free rusher. You don't want to do that. And there's no shot they actually got back on top of that. I thought we had that fumble recovery for sure. I don't know who's letting Nick Bosa run free there, but he's going to get the sack, forces the fumble. We're not going to recover. 3rd and 10 here. Big play for the LA Rams. They are going to pass. Stafford drops back, throws a dime to Cup. Dang it, man. That's tough. That's really tough. Good conversion. 2nd and 3 now. We need to get a stop. We're letting them get chunk plays right now, and that is not good. Gonna fake the counter again, and look at that. It's just so open. Great throw from Stafford. Awesome time to use the lob. I missed my first hit stick, and Allen Robinson has him to the 12. 1st and 10. Really good drive by the Rams to get down into the red zone. Need a stop. Need something. They're just moving the ball too easy. There's pressure. Drake Jackson. He tracks him down all the way across the field. Stafford rolling out. Can't get away. The Rams decide to run the ball on 2nd and 22. Awful play call. Doesn't work out for them. 3rd and 21 here. Let's see what they got. They're going to have that corner. If they wanted to go to that corner to Allen Robinson, they would have had it. Would have been a touchdown. They're gone. They're not going to. You're going to come underneath. It's an 11-yard pickup. That's not enough. They're going to kick a field goal. So we only have a 4-point lead here at about the 2-minute warning, but we are going to... All right. Wow. Okay. That changes everything. Everything. Gotta start from scratch now. That's ridiculous. Trey Lance overshoots a wide open George Kittle, sends it straight to Jalen Ramsey for a pick six. That's tough. I said I wanted to minimize mistakes. That's just one that I can't do anything about. George Kittle is wide open there. Trey Lance just misses him. And I click an extra play. Dang. All right, well, we're down 3 now. We do need to protect the ball. We're going to get the ball back to start the second half, so that is okay. So we're going to run the ball here. Bobby Wagner's trying to get over there for it. We pick up 5. We're going to run chew clock here in case we don't convert. If we do, we'll try to get into field goal range. That's probably it. It's so scary with inconsistent offensive play. So open. That's why we run chew clock. We're going to punt it away now, and we need the defense to get a stop. All right, 1st and 10 from the 16, 34 seconds left on the clock. We got to get them shut down here. We got them. I thought we had a sack. I thought we had the sack. Bosa, and it looked like Drake Jackson trying to track Stafford down, getting his face, force a bad throw, which can't quite get there. 2nd and 10 now, 16-yard line. Ooh, and they're going to dump it off into the flat. All right, a couple of kind of pointless plays, and it's going to be a 3rd and 2 for the Rams here. We just don't want to let them get a big first down out of bounds. Dre Greenlaw lights up Tyler Higbee. It looks like they're going to let the clock run out. That's going to be it for the first half. It's not too bad. All right, we got the ball to start the second half. 1st and 10 from the 25-yard line. Outside of like one play, honestly, we've looked much better than the Rams have. You know, that one missed throw by Trey Lance is going to set us back here. We got to find a way to continue to convert. But we've looked good. We really have. We need to get Jalen Ramsey's X factor off, though. That's going to be really something we don't want to play against for too long. And he's on George Kittle. 3rd and 7 already. We've got to find a way. Oh, he's open. He's open. And we don't get the catch. Okay. We're punting. I don't know what to say. Should have had it all day long. 1st and 10 here. That was a really tough throw for Trey Lance. I can't be that mad. It's just frustrating when you have a guy that's that open and you don't get to take advantage of it. He leaves it short. Oh no, Charvarius Ward, what are you doing? He leaves it short. Dang it. Oh, that was so close. Lockdown coverage results in a 3rd and 2. I want to see Bosa getting pressure. They're going to run it. Oh, he got it. He fell forward at the last second. Dang, so close. So a holding penalty is going to knock him all the way back to a 1st and 20 from the 41-yard line. Puts us in a really, really good spot here. Just no big plays right off rip. And they're going to take the dump off to Tyler Higbee, and he's going to turn it into a decent play. There's supposed to be two people over there watching that, and no one is. The zones are just broken. All right, 2nd and 8. We're still in a decent spot. We just shouldn't have ever given up that play, so it's tough to see it. That one's probably... That's probably on me. Should have been my guy there. I mean, I just... No, it's on me. This is a 3rd and 2, and this is a very important 3rd and 2. Oh, he's got him. It's so obvious right from the start. Quick pass, picks up the first. That should have been a tackle for a loss of like 2 yards. Instead, they picked up 6 on it in the red zone. Those are huge yards. We can't give those up. I mean, honestly, that's huge. That's such a big play. Because we would have been looking at a 3rd and 5 right now. Worst situation. Worst case scenario, 3rd and 5. Instead, it's a 1st and goal on the 8-yard line. Like, that is such a big glitch in Madden. And it just set us so far back in such an important game, too. In such an important game. 2nd and goal. I mean, we need the defense to step up. And Madden doesn't... No, why are you running backwards? Wow. Okay. Ambry Thomas just took off running the wrong direction for no reason. No idea what just happened there. We got to score somewhat quick, and we got to get stopped. I mean, there's just no way around it. That was... Madden decided to take its effect on the game. It does there, and it's going to really hurt us. That's too... One glitch, one play, that's fair enough. I mean, you know, Trey's going to miss throws, but I'm just not excited to see that in that situation. I was throwing the ball the whole way. So we got a 3rd and 18 here. This is, believe it or not, kind of a big play. And I feel like, no, what is that? Wow, okay. Not at all close to what I wanted there. I still have the habit of trying to guide passes, and I know it's not good, but I still do it, and it just doesn't work. No, why did I do it again? Dude, no. We're going to see what happens. 4th and 18, I really want this. Jalen Ramsey's just too good, so we're going to chuck it up to our best player. He should have had it. Quite frankly, he should have had it. The lockdown coverage on Danny Gray has really hurt my offensive game plans. I mean, I love using that speed and just trying to get crossers. It's not working today on any plays, play action, normal crossers, spurts, anything. It's not working. And the little Madden glitches are really hurting too. They're really hurting. I mean, we got to get something here. We can give up a field goal. Just can't give up a touchdown. We got to get a stop. Got to lock in. This is a big, big drive right here. Got to figure they're going to hand off to Akers here. Got to figure. Nope. Dropping back again. Coverage looks decent. Out into the flat. He goes out of bounds. Second and goal from the 4-yard line. We got this. My energy levels just tanked after that first kind of incompletion. It's so open. Wow. I mean, that's Cooper Kupp. That's what he does. That really hurts, though. That really hurts. All right, we gotta find a way. We gotta start moving the ball here. I don't care how. Just gotta find some way. We get Danny Gray finally matched up on someone other than Jalen Ramsey, and shock, surprise, he starts doing his thing. We're gonna see if we can keep getting it done with them. That's not a good throw, dude. I mean, you just can't guide in this game. It's just that obvious. I mean, what am I seeing there? What am I seeing? Am I just that far off my game? We could have taken a short dump off to Kittle. Didn't want it. I'm starting my throw, like, right here. You can see. How is it that far over there? Why is it so hard for him to release? I mean, I'm seeing it, like, right as he's passing Bobby. I'm trying to throw it, and it's... There's so much open field there. There's a solid, like, 20 yards of open field for Lance to throw that. I mean, I guess his release is just that slow. I don't know. I mean, that one feels like it's my fault because it looks like I threw it straight to the defender. But when I'm looking at that, I don't know. I mean, it's not that far downfield. It shouldn't take a long windup. Shouldn't take long for the ball to travel through the air there. Okay, that's just a bad user by me right there. It's just, you know, it's really tough for me to play when I can't layer in those passes in between the levels. That's such a big factor in my offense. And I mean, watching that play back, it just feels like there's so much room to work there. And we didn't get to take advantage of any of it. I mean, I was maybe quarter second late on my read. Oh. That's on me again. I was maybe like a quarter second late on my read there. Almost exactly what I wanted. Gets me intercepted. That's not good. Not acceptable play. But I can't move on from... Wow. What a start to the year, man. What a start to the year. Second and 24 after a ridiculous sack. See, when we have zone, we're able to take advantage of those. And when Lance gets rid of the ball, that is the same distance throw, and he gets it off and gets it there in half the time. I don't know what happened on that last pick. I'm still confused about it. That's a great throw. That's in between the layers. Like I said, that's exactly what I want, and it's a good throw, and it's a big play for us. It gets us in a position to convert here, which we're not going to do. I don't even know. Fourth and four, George Kittle. That's not perfect accuracy, but we'll take it. It's a first down. Second and six. Come on, someone. We're going to run. It's open. Slide. Thank you. Good play by Trey. Second and one here. Coming back underneath to Debo again. It's another first down. That's what we want. It's a third and nine now. We're on the 22-yard line. 25 seconds left. This is going to be another first down. And it's down to the 2-yard line. We're calling a timeout. I just want to get this one touchdown in, man. This is a brutal game. Once we threw that pick with Trey, it just kind of threw the whole vibe of the game off, honestly. I mean, we were dominating on defense. Offense looked good. And then it just tanked. And that pick was 100% not our fault, too. I mean, it just was Madden deciding it didn't want us to be competitive in this game. And that happens sometimes. It just sucks when it does. Trey has a good drive to end it here. That's going to be the video, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. I really do appreciate y'all clicking on it. Wish it could have been a better game. It's tough to lose to a division rival like this, but it happens. I'm going to keep putting videos out. I hope to see you guys clicking on again and again and again. Drop that like, drop that sub, drop that comment. Tell me I suck, because I kind of deserve it after that game. And I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace, guys. This is
mainly Russ's production.